जी सर,
थैंक यू। लास्ट क्लास आई वांटेड टू टॉक अबाउट चैप्टर फाइव। द टाइटल ऑफ योर चैप्टर फाइव इंट्रोडक्शन टू प्लांट्स एंड एनिमल सेल एंड टिश्यू कल्चर टेक्निक्स। दिस चैप्टर अगेन रीड योर 8th semester, a full course, the name of course, Plant Biotechnology, 3-credit course. Last class, I talked few topic, definition of tissue culture, and who is the father of tissue culture, cell culture, definition, tissue culture media, different tissue culture media, pH required for tissue culture 5.8, temperature, light intensity, different vitamins, minerals, carbohydrates and amino acids. Therefore, history of cell and tissue culture. History of cell and tissue culture, we know different scientists first start different procedure to establish the cell and tissue culture. Finally, we know finally Austrian botanist Gottlieb Haberlandet finally established tissue culture protocol, and established different procedures and protocol to regenerate a whole plant from a tissue and cells. Basic techniques of cell culture, culture vessels, different culture vessels need in tissue culture techniques, conical flux, petri dish, culture tubes, culture medium, MS medium, B5 medium, W medium, NITS medium, and some other mediums need in tissue culture. Tissue culture technique as a nutrition supplement during tissue culture work, we always maintain the pH and also adjust pH 5.8. If after the preparation of medium, if pH more than 5.8, then we add some acids to decrease the pH level. And when pH lower than 5.8, we include few drops of alkali to increase the pH level, and we always adjusted pH 5.8 for tissue culture. Sterilization. For sterilization purpose, we always set up autoclave programming 121 degrees Celsius for 15 minutes and 15 LBS for inoculation and maintain the sterile condition of tissue culture instrument and different apparatus. Basic techniques of tissue culture. Last class we discussed how we'll prepare sample. First sample resize by scissor or any cutting device, then wash by mercurous chloride or 70% alcohol, therefore it transferred to conical flux containing nutrients medium. Therefore, incubate it and transfer in storeroom, in which we always maintain temperature and light intensity. Then it prepare a callus, undifferentiated cell. Therefore, it also initiates rooting and stem or shooting. If it enlarges and size day by day increase, then it is transferred to greenhouse for maintenance and study of temperature and growth, and therefore it will transfer to plantlets in greenhouse, and we also observe and collection of data, growth status and others. Therefore, it will transfer to farmer for commercial cultivation. Inoculation, therefore incubation, we must maintain temperature 26 to 28 degrees Celsius and light intensity 2000 to 4000 lux. And we allowing 16 hours of light and 18 hours of darkness during incubation period. And we also collect data during growth status, medium condition and others. Induction of callus, I already talked with you. After the inoculation of plants, the plant portion swelling and first form a undifferentiated tumor like cell. It is called callus. Therefore, it undergoes rooting on the lower portion and shooting stem, leaves and plant upper parts in above side. Then morphogenesis, organogenesis and embryogenesis, different organs of plants, leaf, buds, stem is day by day increase, and therefore embryogenesis, embryo form, first form flower, then changes to form a embryo, then create a seeds. We also used these seeds, normal vegetation and growth of new plants. Last, hardening, I also discuss when plants is adjust and tolerance in different ranges of temperature and normal growth and regeneration done, then it is transferred to farmers for commercial cultivation. The next topic, basic culture requirement. I already discussed above. First, we maintain aseptic condition to get a sterile plant and desired plant. Therefore, we always maintain the appropriate environment, such as light intensity, temperature, and sterile working area. Basic facilities for plants tissue culture operations involving any type of in vitro procedures must include certain essential elements washing and storage facilities, media preparation, transfer area, culture rooms, observation or data collection area, transplantation area. Then we will design a desired tissue culture lab to maintain the aseptic condition and sterile area. First, in lower area, we entry in laboratory for start the daily expected work. Then first we will sit bench, then sink and stills. This sink containing some sterile material. We first rinse our hand and foot by 70% ethanol. Then we will wear a lab coat, goggles, mask and hand gloves. And therefore, we will entry in laboratory, and in this design laboratory, right side chemical store, analytical room, photo and dark room. In this area, photo and dark room, we always collect sample and observe this room and collect photo and data for further analysis. In sterile area, we use laminar airflow. Already talked last class, laminar airflow is it? We use laminar airflow to maintain the sterile working area and sterile condition. This area we first on UV light for 30 minutes, then all pathogenic microorganisms died. Therefore, we on normal light to continue daily work. In area, we dissection sample and inoculate in culture media. Culture media, therefore, it transferred in store room for observation and washing up room, culture room with shelves. In culture rooms and shelf, we will store samples for observation and normal routine work and key data collection. Washing and storage facility area, we wash different culture vessels, and therefore it sterile for next use. Media preparation room and stores. In media preparation room, we use different types of glassware, balances, electric balance and other balances, required chemicals, hot plates, stirrer, water bath, pH meter, autoclave, hot air oven, micro oven, vortex shaker, centrifuge, refrigerator and freezer, storage cabinet. Therefore, transfer area. In transfer area, we already work with. In transfer area, we use laminar airflow cabinet. Laminar airflow cabinet, already talked with. Laminar airflow cabinet contain a filter, high efficiency particulate air filter. This filter porosity is 0.3 micron. And we know the microorganisms normal size is 0.5 micron. In this case, no any microorganism entry into the filter in this laboratory. This filter purify water, different toxic pathogenic microorganisms kill in this filter, and hot air exit from laboratory and cool air enter in this laboratory by HEPA filter. कालसर रूम, कालसर रूम, इन कालसर रूम वी ट्राई टू मेंटेन द टेम्परेचर, नॉर्मल टेम्परेचर 25 प्लस माइनस 2 डिग्री सेल्सियस. डेटा कलेक्शन एरिया, इन डेटा कलेक्शन एरिया वी ऑलवेज कलेक्ट फोटो एंड ऑब्जर्व द ग्रोथ एंड growth and regeneration status from day by day, and we collect data previous day and next day to prepare a data file. Transplantation area, already we talk with transplantation area. In transplantation area, we first transplant cancer plant from conical flux to plantlets, and then it is observed in greenhouse for few days for normal growth and cultivation. Therefore, it is transferred to farmers for commercial cultivation. New topic: application of plant cell and tissue culture. Plant cell, how you use plant tissue culture. First, we use tissue culture to conserve rare or endangered species in biodiversity, to get sterile plants, to get secondary metabolites and recombinant product used for biopharmaceuticals. We used different plant species to get different properties, such as STE, stress tolerance plant, drought tolerance plant, some transgenic plants, herbicide resistance plant and insect resistance plant, and different types of disease-free plants such as potatoes, and different types of important properties is able to create by tissue culture technique. Components of cell culture media with function. A cell culture media or nutrients media generally contain some sources: carbon source, amino acid, vitamin, balance salt, phenol red dye, carbonate buffer. Functions of carbon source of energy, amino acid. The main function of amino acid: building blocks of protein, vitamins promote cell survival and growth. And finally, bicarbonate buffer, it is used to maintain a balanced pH in the media. This component generally contain a culture media for proper growth of plants. Next, totipotency. Totipotency is the ability of a single cell to divide the produce, all of the differentiated cells in an organism. So, totipotency is the ability is a single cell to divide and produce a differentiated cell in an organism. Thus, a single cell, tissue or organ, is able to produce a complete plant. This capacity is called totipotency. Just a definition for your exam. Sometimes it is I give it final examination. Haploid, a cell containing half of the number of homologous chromosome in somatic cell. Half of the number of the homologous chromosome in somatic cell is called haploid. Just n number of cell is called haploid, and 2n number is called diploid. We know 23 pairs of chromosome found in a complete organism. 46 chromosome. 46 chromosome. One pair is called autosome and 22 pair is called, one pair is called 6 chromosome and 20 pair is called, 22 pair is called autosome. Next, micropropagation. Micropropagation is another technique of tissue culture. It is one kinds of tissue culture in which we use stock plant material that is previously collected as a specific characteristics in our laboratory, and it is used to produce a whole plant by tissue culture technique is called key micropropagation. Steps of micropropagation. Micropropagation generally complete by 4 steps: establishment, multiplication, pre-transplant, last transfer from culture. Already we talk in tissue culture methods. First established. First we collect sample and is processed. Therefore, it is prepared and after cut and wash, it transferred to culture media. It is establishment. Multiplication. After incubation, when it is form a callus, then it undergoes to rooting and shooting. Then it is transferred to conical flux, large size of conical flux. Then it is transferred to plantlets. Finally, it is transferred to greenhouse to observe the normal growth development day by day. Then finally it is transferred to, when it is observed normal growth and optimum, therefore it is transferred for commercial cultivation. Advantages of micropropagation. Micropropagation has a similar advantage as tissue culture. Disease-free plant. To produce a disease-free plant, different types of secondary metabolites containing recombinant protein, some biopharmaceuticals, sterile culture condition for the generation of new characteristics such as cell wall, increase the cell wall thickness, slow ripening, and we develop taste, size of the plants, fruits, and production of large production generally used micropropagation technique. Some disadvantages also occur in micropropagation. Very expensive, can labor cost of more than 70%, and some disadvantages also occur. And infected plant samples can produce infected progeny. Some plants are very difficult to disinfect fungal organism. When we culture, sometimes we observe few culture infected by fungal, and therefore it is very difficult to remove, to get a sterile plant. Last topic of this chapter. Plant tissue culture may offer certain advantages of a traditional method of propagation. We know if we do not use tissue culture, generally different propagative method we also generally use, by seed cutting methods, and some methods generally available in our society and also in our farmer. But if we want to get some specific advantages, then we must use tissue culture to get more advantages, in which if we get good flower, fruits, have the other desired traits to quickly produce massive plants, we can use plant tissue culture technique. We also discuss if we get disease-free plants, insect-resistant plant, and some desired characteristics such as slow-ripening plants. Now we see the tomato in market available. This tomato collect from farmers, and it shows in market for few months. Same color, in which slow ripening. In this case, a technology, tissue culture technology, modern tissue culture technology, antisense RNA technology, flower sour technology is used to create this type of properties. Last, to clear particular plants and viral and other infections, and to quickly multiply these plants as a cleaned stock for horticulture and agriculture. So we declare that modern tissue culture technology is more advantageous over traditional methods of propagation. Finally, plant tissue culture as a basis for genetic engineering. Genetic engineering methods is generally used to upgrade and more advantageous by tissue culture technique. I already talked, if we get herbicide and insect resistance plant, first we isolate a gene, BT gene. BT gene is generally collected from a Bacillus thuringiensis, a microorganism. BT gene is anti-pesticidal or anti-insecticidal properties. If we first isolate a BT gene from Bacillus thuringiensis and then it is incorporated to plants, it develops an antibody in plants when no need to more use a chemical pesticide or different synthetic pesticides in plants to save plants from insect or pest. Similar, some studies, BT brinjal. We know brinjal, corolla, and some other plants daily need a spray different types of toxic chemicals, pesticides to control from insect pest. If we develop this type of plants by biopesticide, plant incorporated protectant, no need to more different types of toxic chemicals or pesticides to save plants. It is healthy and non-toxic from health. We also discuss different methods such as protoplast fusion and culture. It is generally used to get a sterile plant. It is also not harmful for living system. Genetically engineered tissue culture draft can grown be filled when government regulated biosafety guidelines are followed to save, minimize risks of genes flow to native germ plasm and reduce impact on the components of the ecosystem. So we called tissue culture technique, if we use genetic engineering approaches or recombinant DNA technology, then it is not harmful to living system. And when we follow the biosafety guideline, it is advantageous and to fulfill the ongoing high demand of different vegetables, different greens and different plants that we generally consume daily. Thank you. Your today class end, and we will start next class plasmid. Thank you.